This is one of my first, actually it is my first school visit in Alberta and my first time here in Calgary, or Alberta for that matter, and I'm very excited to be here, and it's definitely my first time seeing O Canada, and I did not know the words, and I sort of caught on by then, so you guys have taught me something. I hope that by coming here today, I'm going to be able to teach you something about reading, writing, and the fun that we can all have doing that. We're going to do a collaborative writing activity, and we're going to have some of a Halloween theme around that. But before I begin, you might be wondering why a 13-year-old is talking to you today instead of maybe a 33-year-old or something like that. So I do have a few credentials, actually, to be exact. When I was 7, I published my first book, Flying Fingers, Master the Tools of Learning to Enjoy a Friend, which I'm now trying to extract with one hand. Flying Fingers, here it is. And it's a book of short stories. And the reason that I wanted to publish a book when I was 7 was because when I started reading, I was actually 3.5 years old. And then I started writing when I was 4. And I would write stories like every day. I would just write pages and pages of them. When I got a laptop, I'd type them all up. Sometimes I wouldn't want to go eat dinner because I was so engrossed in whatever I was writing. And when I was around 7 years old, then I had written over 300 short stories. And I thought, well, these stories are all just leave on my computer. I want them to go somewhere. And so I decided to publish a book. And from that, when I started speaking at schools to students very much like you in my own home state of Washington, as well as around the world. Now, you might be wondering why so many students would really want to hear from someone like me to talk about reading and writing. A lot of it was because I was someone their own age, as well as the fact that I would do collaborative writing exercises. But I want to hear from you on whether you like reading or writing. Raise your hand if you like to read or write. I'm seeing some raised hands. Some people are like not really sure, and other people don't. Okay, so I see some raised hands. Well, let's try to figure out exactly what we all love about it. Let's we're going to open up a Word document, and we're going to write down our favorite things about reading and writing. Why do you like it so much? What does it mean?
Change the font.